Hi there, this is Ronnie Amber's Night, coming at you with a video. I found myself in the last few weeks getting interested again in this whole issue of scenarios, writing adventures, scenarios, campaigns, etc. For multiple systems. And it intrigues me. I am someone who owns a few different fantasy systems, a few different sci-fi systems, a few different horror systems. And how it started for me was wanting to write an introductory horror scenario that I would run for brand new players. Not the smartest idea in the world, I will grant you, because I still think horror is not the best genre to start new players on, but, you know. And the games that I have that I could use for horror are Call of Cthulhu, Cult. I also own Savage Worlds with a horror companion, and True 20. I've got the revised edition of True 20, which, rather than having campaign setting ideas, actual specific settings in the background, which happened in the first edition, the revised edition went with a companion of having a whole section dedicated to running fantasy games, one for horror, one for space, one for modern. Personally, I would have ditched the modern and then went for a section on running supers, but you know, or pulp action. But you know, mine is not the reason why. But anyway. And that was really my thought. I mean, I do own Angel, the RPG based on the TV show. And the only reason I wouldn't consider horror for that one, strangely enough, is because I don't consider it a horror system. Regardless of its subject matter, it always comes across to me as urban fantasy. So for me, I wouldn't use it for straight up horror. It's more fantasy and modern dress for me, albeit with a darker edge. But that's a sort of personal view. For fantasy, I have a slew of them. Again, Savage Worlds, because I've got Fantasy Companion, TRI-20. I've got Dragon Age, Dragon Warriors, Basic Fantasy, Palladium. I also have Blue Rose. I also have Song of Ice and Fire. And I have Pendragon. But as they're very low magic systems, which are more grounded in a sort of grittier feel, if you like, rather than sort of high fantasy. I've attempted to write games that were stated for both of those games separately. And I like this idea of writing games for multiple systems. But it leaves me with an interesting conundrum as to how I do it. Part of me kind of wants to do what the old White Dwarf magazine used to do in the 80s, when it used to do multiple sets. It would write its adventure, and then it would have the stat blocks for a creature, say. There is one called a Bag of Bones, which was a basic D&D Dragon Warriors adventure. And it would have like a creature or NPC started, and it would have the stats for D&D and then the stats for Dragon Warrior. That I like the idea of doing multiple stats like that, doing the stat blocks. The only thing is that I would want to stat for the games I own, and I've got a good 6 or 7, so the stat blocks would be quite long. So I think if I did that, I would stat block them at the end of the adventure, and just sort of code it as, you know, you get to such and such a place, you have encounter one, and then at the end of the adventure you have the list of this is encounter one and the different stats for the different systems. That's one way of doing it. The other way is possibly going down the Freeport route, which is to write the adventure completely generic without a stat in it, and then release separate books with the stats for each specific system. You know, write the scenario, no stats or anything in it, and then write specific information for Dragon Warrior, specific information for Dragon Age, and so on and so forth. So that if you are someone who, say, owned Dragon Age, all you would do is you would take the main book and then you would take the stat list for Dragon Age. So you're not piling through things. So I haven't quite decided which one I'm going to use yet. There are merits to both. The interesting thing, of course, is, me being me, when it comes to fantasy, I don't have a lot of the biggest. I don't have any version of D&D currently. The only version of D&D I would even consider having is possibly AD&D 2nd edition again. Or if I could find the D&D rule cyclopedia for a decent price. I am very tempted to get the printed out version of Dark Dungeons for that very reason, because it's the closest to the rule cyclopedia that's out there. Obviously it's missing a couple of TSR's more copyrighted creatures, but otherwise it's pretty much D&D. The old Beckman D&D system, the rule cyclopedia. And I'm very tempted by that. And if I did have that, I would stat it. Basic fantasy is something that's been derived from the OGL to emulate AD&D first edition. So I suppose that would be a D&D-ish. But I don't own 3rd edition, 3.5, 4th edition, 5th edition. No interest in it. And I don't own Pathfinder. So, as usual, I have, you know, limited fan base for such a thing. So I'm intrigued. I'm interested. I'm enthused. I'm cautious, but I'm very interested in doing it. Not sure how it'll turn out. And obviously, it wouldn't just be fantasy for me. I want to do a fantasy one, I want to do a horror one. I'd like to do a sci-fi. But we'll see. It's just me musing, a few thoughts out there. If anyone's got any comments, feel free to leave them. And I'll be back with another video very soon.